great job on that previous report, Thomas.
Thank you, sir.
Took you long enough, but you finally got it turned in. Hey, those spreadsheets, do you have those for me today?
Well, no, sir, not yet. I've been very...
Yeah, very busy lately. You've been using that excuse constantly, Thomas. Okay, I'll extend the deadline by another week, but that's it. Got it?
Yes, sir. I'm sorry, sir.
Yeah, sorry. That only works so many times, Thomas, and then people stop paying attention. And we're nearly there.
Yes, sir.
What is it, Soja? You don't want to eat. Well, come on, you have to. Don't you want to be as big and strong as your father over here? Now take a look at your mother, who hasn't eaten a single vegetable in all her life. Now eat your vegetables, Sunshine. I know Mommy lets you eat what you want to, but she doesn't know what's best for you. I told her not to leave the door unlocked. Didn't I, Sunshine? I told her to always check and make sure it was locked, but she would always forget. She didn't listen. You didn't listen! No, Sunshine. So eat your vegetables, because I know what's best for you. I always know what's best for you.
Nice car.
please leave.
Excuse you?
Look, I'm really not in the mood for this.
Look, man, we're just trying to have a nice conversation. Yeah. Maybe convince you to give us that car of yours. But it seems like the nice way isn't going to work, so I guess I have to use something else. See you around.
What?
You heard me, Thomas. You're fired. With a capital F.
Wait, no, no, no. Sir. Sir, you can't fire me.
Yes, I can. I did.
Sir, you can't. I've worked here just as hard as anyone else, if not more so.
Yeah, that's true. But they all turn their work in on time, on deadline. You turn it in whenever you want, whenever it's convenient for you.
I've been busy.
Look, Thomas, your work is exceptional. When you turn it in.
Sir, I've been very busy. Sir, please, listen to me. Sir!
We need people here who will turn the work in on time, on deadline, every single time. Thomas, I'm sorry.
Sir. I'm not sorry. If you were sorry, you would know what it feels like to come home from work one day and find your family taken from you. If you were sorry, you would know what it feels like to have to move to a place where you can't feel safe without having a gun in your pocket. If you were sorry, you would know what it feels like to live alone and in fear. So don't you dare say you're sorry to me, Nathan, when both of us know that you're really not.
Thomas!
Out of my way. Sunshine, I'm home. Sunshine! She sees me. She sees me standing out here like this, and yet she chooses to ignore me. As if to make matters worse, they continue to laugh as if to mock me. Much better.
lovely place you guys have here. You know, I used to live here. It was mine. Ours, actually. That was a long time ago. Yes, a long time ago. Came home from work one day, and my wife and my Lily were gone. She's your everything. And the next, she's gone. And your everything is taken away from you. And you're left all alone. Do you have any idea what that feels like? You're about to.
Tell you what, why don't you go home and just try doing some other things for a while?
I don't think I want to be doing anything else right now. Come on, Mrs. Grant, just give me a few more weeks. I promise you, I'll come up with something for the publishing.
So,
please. Yeah, I'll be there in about 15 minutes, okay? Alright, you too, bye.
So, did she like it?
Yeah, I think she actually liked it this time.
See? I told you'd come up with something. When's it getting published?
I wouldn't know.
Well, when you start getting rich and popular, you should make your next novel about me. Call it Agent Vincent.
It'll be like a mix between James Bond and Jason Bourne. I'll be traveling across the whole world. It'll be filled with intense action, suspense, and drama.
And throughout the whole thing, I'll be making those one-liners like they do in those...
Can we get married?
You know we can't afford it, Zoe. I just got a new job. We owe a huge sum of money to your sister. We're already behind on this month's rent. Listen, we're both working as hard as we can. When your book gets published, maybe in the next 5 years, we can have the most beautiful wedding you can possibly imagine.
I'm pregnant, Vince.
Wait. What?
I'm pregnant.
Pregnant? As in, you have a baby in your belly?
Last time I checked, that's what being pregnant meant.
Oh my god. I want to be a father.
Calm down, will you?
You're going to be a mother. Aren't you excited?
I'm more scared than excited. I mean, I'm not ready to be anybody's mom.
But you're great with your brother's kids.
Because I don't have to live with them. I just get to be the cool auntie. Look.
I can't.
You say it yourself. We can barely support ourselves, much less a child.
You'll be a great mother. I know you, Zoe. And I know you'll be able to do anything that life throws at you. And I'm here with you. We've been through a lot. So we just need to embark on this new journey, together.
But what about our bills?
Screw the bills. Who cares about them right now? I'm gonna be a father.
You know, Colin always said it would never work out between us two. My brother, Colin.
Which one is that?
The one you don't like.
Oh, him.
He used to think whenever you came by the house that you liked him.
Did he?
Yeah, he used to think you only hung out with me just to get to him.
He was a clever one, wasn't he?
Yeah, well, please don't tell him when we meet up for Thanksgiving dinner. But if you do, just don't tell him I was the one who told you.
Most certainly will.
Okay.
office room, grab the phone, and call the cops. Stay there no matter what, okay? You hear me? We'll be safe.
What about you?
I'll be fine. I'm just going to try to buy you some time.
I can't.
So I love you, Mom.
Zoe!
Came home from work one day, and my wife and my Lily were gone. Weeks go by, they find them beaten to death and abandoned in the woods.
Yes, there's a man in our house, and he has a gun. Our address is 281 Burke Street. Please hurry.
The address is 281 Burke Street.
Here.
Hello?
I'm here.
Oh my God.
What did I do?
Unbelievable. He's started shooting at the two of them and followed them into the house.
Did you see anything else?
No, but I heard more gunshots coming from inside the house.
Okay. Well, thank you, Miss Byron. That'll be all.
Glad to be of help.
What a mess.
Yeah. Where's the husband?
Being interrogated back at the station.
Looks like everything's been cleared up, Mr. Rogers. Officer Nielsen here will take you home now.
I'm really sorry about what happened.